Please introduce yourself and what you do.
Hi, I'm Jonnie Jensen. I'm the founder of Live and Social. I'm a social media strategist, and we help clients understand how to use social technologies to make their team more productive, collaborate better, and of course externally to help them reach customers better, to find prospects and to use social media channels effectively.
Oh, that was good. So social media for you personally, how's it helping you? You know, what's your objective for using it in for the business?
Personally, it's about my profile. It's about my influence and reach. I want to connect with people I'm going to learn from. Ideally, I'd like to be sharing stuff that they're interested in as well, so that they might connect or comment back to me. On a personal level, I've got friends in different places in the world, family in different places in the world. So my social presence really is for me a daily part of my life. And it's a great way for me to feel connected to the people who are most important to me.
Right. And so for clients, how do you start off there? What do you find that most people's objectives are from a client perspective? What are they after?
I think still a lot of clients don't really know what social can do for them.
Yeah.
Increasingly now, of course, they know it's there. But what we do when we speak to them is we really want to align the social activities with the business goals and objectives, the existing ones. So we're not trying to achieve something new. They know what's going to make their business successful.
Yeah.
We want to put social strategies in place that are going to help them achieve that success.
Because it's become another marketing channel, or because it's...
Definitely a marketing channel, but that's another important part of it. They think it's just a marketing channel, but then we talk to them about how this can influence your product cycle and how your products are going to produce customer services, HR, customer loyalty, or attracting the best possible talent. So when we start talking to them about, you know, do you realise this can affect these areas of your business? And if we're doing that well, then it's going to be a great marketing story.
Right.
You can't put the marketing at the front, really. I mean, we don't really do campaigns. I mean, I like to say that we're not an agency in that respect. We support people in their campaigns, but I want people, our clients, to know that this is a long-term, always-on, always making a difference work.
So what sort of routines do you have personally when you're doing, you know, when do you do your social media? Do you do it riding your bike, in the car, you know, on the at home? You know,
I'm frightened to say, I do actually sometimes tweet when I'm riding my bike, but I won't tell my children that. You can imagine, I've worked in the internet since 1999. It's a daily part of my life, so I make good use of tools. Google Reader, rest in peace, but now Feedly is probably my curator of choice. I have RSS feeds and alerts coming in that bring me the latest content.
And when do you do that? Do you do it at coffee breaks, or do you do it at the end of the day, beginning of the day? How do you set yourself up to do that?
Quite often it'll be in the morning. Before my children were toddlers, I would do it, you know, when they woke up, but now I'm busy. But I grab points of the day, and certainly that kind of evening time when it's actually my kind of downtime, I don't think anything to browsing through my social channels and sharing and engaging and talking to people.
And what are you generally advising for clients? What are you trying to get them to do themselves in terms of routine?
I use the analogy of going to the gym. You know, would you like to get up in the morning and go and ache and get sweaty and like, no, thanks very much. But if you'd like to get up and do something that helps you be happy, successful, sexier, you know, live longer, they're like, oh, great, how do I do that? And so that daily routine has to start, though, with just a small activity that you can build on once you start to find some success. You know, I go to the gym and I start to feel myself getting fitter, then that encourages me to go more. And so as they use the tools that we recommend, as we give them a proposition to follow, I mean, that's a key part. What am I going to tweet about? What am I going to talk about? We work with them so they're really clear about what they're going to tweet and talk about, and then it becomes so much easier. And like I said, daily habits. So we help them curate content through tools. We help give them advice and guidance on what to tweet or how to tweet. And most importantly in all this is expecting to get engagement from people that don't engage is a pointless exercise. Key influencers and engaging with communities that are active, that's a really strong message that we put across to our clients, because that's when they start to have success, and that's when that makes our job easier.
Yeah, and how, you know, have you got in terms of, can you recall any, you know, success stories that, you know, you've thought up, you know, that when you've been out there, done stuff for clients that have really made an impact, what sort of what are the big sort of wins and things that you could?
Yeah, well one of our clients, Source, they won recruitment blog of the year for 2012, won that award in December. And in terms of wins, and it didn't come instantly, that blog was live for over 18 months before that award was won, but it's a process of the brand or the company creating content and having a brand profile and presence supported by a community manager or someone who really wants to do it in the business. But then it's no use that single channel trying to promote and leverage that content. We want the team to be active.
Yeah.
And so the success comes when the team are really active and they're sharing out that content as well. And with Source, one of London's leading recruitment agencies, they're now seeing the fruits of that strategy because they've got 25, nearly 30 people sharing the content. That's driving significant traffic to their website. About 15% of their traffic comes from the social sharing. And fundamentally, it's driven by the team with a great content to share.
And you've got the whole team. So from the executives down to the middle managers and everyone, you know.
There's people that will do it. And there's people that will do it reluctantly.
Right.
And we look to support as many of those people as possible.
That want to
but
do
you've
it.
Got to have champions and you've got to have kind of the running along at the back at their own pace.
Yeah. Any other big successes that you can share with us? You don't have to say the name.
Yeah, I mean, video content, as you might imagine, has started to
really
drive success for our clients.
Yeah.
And the importance of it being... And we're doing it now, you know, it's good quality but disposable content. It doesn't have to be something that they're spending thousands of pounds on.
Yeah.
And we've put together a video team here and they're well skilled, but we try and do it as efficient, as effective way as possible. And YouTube channels where we've doubled, you know, literally since last month, we just done a quarterly report for one of our clients and their total views have doubled in a month. And it's small beginnings, but when you go from 1,000 to 2,000 views, 1,000 in total up to that month, and in this month we've added another 1,000 on top, they're, in terms of taking that back up to the management, they're like, all right, I get it. It really works.
So in terms of creating content and blogs, what's your kind of personal and also from the client's perspective, how do you get people to do that?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not here to make stuff up. It's, you know, it's a challenge in running my business, in finding time to blog, but it's definitely about having a calendar that you're working to.
Yeah.
You know, I always say to clients, the Sunday Times didn't get written on Saturday afternoon. Bits of it are topical and did, but the rest of it was definitely planned out.
Yeah.
And so myself, I've got a list of blog titles that I'm working to, and I don't always pull from it. But as blog ideas come up, or as I'm reading something else, I'll stick it in. We use Wunderlist, or go into Wunderlist, and that'll be something I can go back to and work on. We have a strategy where we're feeding those titles into a set of categories. You know, blogs have categories, so we create content that fits those categories. And I honestly take a lot of inspiration from other blogs that I'm reading. That doesn't mean I copy it, but you know, there's very little fresh content. Now, if you're thought leadership, then great, it really needs to be in your own thoughts. But sometimes I'll see something, I'm like, oh yeah, a client just asked me last week. I answered it, why didn't I turn it into a blog post? And I'll go away and turn it into a blog post.
Yeah, cool. So finally, Jonnie, top tips for people wanting to start the journey. So you're a small business or a mid-sized business. People may have dabbled around the edges. What are the top tips for getting involved?
So I got asked this question yesterday, and someone was saying, "Oh, social media isn't working." And I took them through three stages. The first stage is the proposition. So why would someone want to follow you? What is it that you're going to do for them? How is it going to add value to their life, make them faster, happier, sexier, cheaper? And then when you've got that clear, not only can you actually say that to people, by following us, you'll get this, and you can expect this from us, but it also becomes the process that you can stick to. It's the framework that you can operate to in your business. Then the second part of it is the content planning. A content matrix that we work to is, what do we want people to know about us? What do people always ask us? And then topical, trending, sort of newsjacking things, and then guest posts, who could write for us on this topic that knows about it better than us. So that getting that content right and planned out is stage two. And then the final part is the community and the conversation. So yeah, follow lots of people, but really focus on key influencers. Look to find those key influencers and build relationship with them. Really acknowledge them for their content and what you're learning from them, and have them notice you, so that when your content is shared by them, you're really amplifying your reach. And those 3 points, proposition, content and conversation, are what really underpin anyone's social media success.
Brilliant. Jonnie, thanks very much.
Thanks for having me. Oh.